All right, we're here. We got Voss water now. That's how you know we're leveling up, is that we got Voss water. We went from Zen to Essentia to Voss water. This is not sponsored by Voss water, like every episode, sponsored by Starbucks. Pending on Starbucks ever seeing one of these videos and sponsoring it, but regardless, sponsored by Starbucks. Regardless, you know what I mean? So they will one day. I'm going to manifest that right now, that one day Starbucks will sponsor me. I don't know in what capacity. I don't know how, but it's going to happen. We're getting into the shit, and the mic stand's a little wobbly, but that's okay. And without further ado, that makes me excited to say welcome back to episode 10, woo, of the Mackin Show. So, double digits. We finally made it to episode 10. Didn't think we'd get past episode like 3 or 4. Not exactly sure. It started out as a fun concept. I wanted to test out the podcast studio. Started to have fun with it. Secured our first guest, who I'm not gonna say who it is yet, but we got a fun guest coming, and we're officially gonna start rolling in guests from time to time. Now, it's gonna be hectic as fuck because work is super hectic right now. There is so much going on, from new brand stuff coming out, which I can't tell you about just yet, but it's gonna be super fun. I know a lot of people watching this are also just like, who do you work for? And all this type of stuff. So I don't know. I have conversations with people like that at work. I don't want to be that guy to be like, yeah, I work. You know what I mean? It's like, it's a weird thing sometimes when you work in LA and you don't want to like be that person to be like, yeah, I work for this, like, and act like you're trying to get something out of it. That's why I do, you know, my own little podcast and stuff. So I'll reveal all that at some point too. But regardless, new brand stuff coming out. It's going to be this one. I'm excited for this one. This one's going to be really cool. So that's all I can tell you at the moment, is it's going to be really cool. I'm obsessed with it. I think it's going to be super awesome. But on, you know, when you're launching a new brand, stuff gets hectic. You got rollout plans, you got marketing strategies, you got to get social stuff set up. So there's a lot going on right now. Obviously, there's a lot going on the entertainment side too. So there's just so many things happening right now in a good way. Like, it's all super fun, all cool, but just like a lot of things happening. So, you know, that's what's going on work life wise. We just got done house sitting for Caitlin for the last 5 days, and it was good. It made me know now that, you know, Caitlin and Brett are married. They got their lives together. They're doing good, for lack of a better term. They're doing good. So Rivy, their beautiful, beautiful golden retriever, we watch her too. But it always makes me know that. And mind you, I've grown up with a dog from literally ages 0 to 22. I'm not meant for a dog right now. I'm not. It's a lot of responsibility. It's a lot of tending to. It's, you know, it's your child for that point. And let me tell you, Caitlin treats Rivy like her child, which is great. And I don't have that. To watch other people's dogs, I have that responsibility. Absolutely. Because it's for short periods of time. It's for, you know, it's not. That's not your dog. Like, when we watch Josh's dog, Buddy, I would kidnap Buddy in a second. Best dog, and I love Buddy. Buddy, if you're watching this and you can understand English, I love you. But no, Buddy was awesome. But, you know, it's a lot of responsibility when it's your own dog. We're working all the time. Like, you're not home as much. So, yeah, and we were house-sitting for a little while. That was good. It made me feel a little – we were in Beverly. It made me feel a little bougie. So we've really been doing that, and we just had a Grove pop up that went fucking awesome. The whole event went great. Emma planned it out. It was awesome. And you know, there's going to be a really cool YouTube video coming for that soon. Don't know the exact date it's going to get put out, but it's coming soon. So be on the lookout for that. But no, the Grove stuff has been going great recently. Got to meet Rick Caruso, who owns the Grove and owned a ton of Los Angeles, super nice guy, also golden retriever owner, and he brought his golden, which anytime you bring your dog to an event, fan favorite, love it. Brought his golden to the event. It was such a fun time. Sheena was there, the family, Jack Wright, Leo Skeppy, who, so I didn't know who Leo was prior to knowing him over the past 2.5 weeks, 6'7", giant, jacked. Like, he can look intimidating to most people. And to me, I was most people. When I saw him, I didn't think he was going to be mean, but I was just like, oh shit, like, this dude's huge. Like, oh my God. Nicest fucking dude. Like, so normal. Like, so, so normal. Like, when after I met him and, like, had conversations with him and realized, like, oh my God, like, you're so nice. Went and dove into his content and so fucking normal. Like, talks about real shit from, like, mental health and lifestyle shit and just, like, what he goes through on a day-to-day. But on top of that, he wasn't like, so mental health is something that, you know, we have to take seriously. Like, it wasn't like some PR shit, which if you're talking about mental health, great, regardless, as long as there's a conversation going on about it. But he goes, and he's like, fuck shit. Like, he talks like how I would talk back home. So love him for that. Leo Skeppy, nice ass dude. Yeah, so I was really glad I got to meet him recently, hoping we'll be seeing more of him. His podcast is fucking awesome. His Sophia Franklin rant was not hilarious. It was hilarious just because, like, it shows, like, and he really went in on Fox News because it shows the way the media will, like, screw with shit, where on their podcast, Sophia was just like, yeah, like, you know, I want to check a guy's bank account when we're dating. And they just took that one clip and we're like, oh my God, look at her, gold digger, blah, blah, bitch, she's a millionaire. So, and it sounds like I'm quoting Leo, but just in general, like, they take that one clip. It's like, she's Sophia Franklin. Like, we know who she is. She's making her own money. Like, and who gives a fuck about comments like that anyways? Like, I think, oh, that was the air conditioning. I take those, I want to see his bank account comments, like, funny as fuck. Like, I would be so caught off guard if a girl was like, yeah, I want to see your bank account, that I might actually give her my bank account information. She's going to be pretty goddamn disappointed because she's going to be like, ooh, okay, like, you're not what I'm looking for. But I personally think it would be funny. So, no, I thought that was dope. It's been a good week. Shit's going to get way more hectic. One of my best friends from back home who lives in Denver, Pete, is going to be visiting me here in like 2 days. He stays for 5 days. Pete is one of the most interesting people I've ever met. I fucking love Pete. Hopefully you'll be able to meet him soon here on this, but I just have to put it that he's the most interesting fucking person I've met. He's your typical, lives in Denver, loves going to EDM shit, loves psychedelics, like loves life. And I love Pete, and he's a sous chef, and I don't know. I get almost the happiest for him because, like, he was not dealt great cards to start out life. And on top of not being dealt great cards, didn't make some good decisions. So it was 50-50. Some were dealt, some were made. Regardless, he's doing fucking great now. He's chefing it up in Denver, and he's coming here to visit. So I'm fucking hype. Obviously, he's only going to be here for like 4 days, and there's a ton of work stuff. So hopefully I'll be able to show him a good time while he's here, but I'm really happy to see him. So shout out to fucking Pete. I love you. Speaking of love, love is both dead and alive right now in Hollywood. And as in dead, it's sad that Sophie Turner and Joe Jonas have called it quits. They called it quits. There's so many relationships where they call it quits, and I'm like, yeah, I could see that one coming. I didn't see this one coming. I was actually surprised. I didn't watch Game of Thrones, but Sophie Turner seems dope. So, I mean, I knew her from Game of Thrones and just, like, being in the public eye. Obviously, I know Joe Jonas very well. And I just did not see them as being kaput. I did not see them, you know, getting a divorce that wasn't in my 2023 cards. But it happened. They said cutting it. And there's stories, like, here and there of, like, supposedly something was caught on a Ring camera. Supposedly the different lifestyles of, like, she still wants to party, he's more of a homebody, but there's evidence against that because he likes to party. I mean, dude's a musician. Of course he loves to party. And he lives in New York City and LA. He loves to party, obviously. And then, what was I going to say? Supposedly the postpartum thing was an issue. I don't know. Am I best friends with Sophie Turner or Joe Jonas? No, I am not. So I don't fucking know the real information. All I know is they are divorced, so, or at least on their way to divorce. So that's kind of sad. I think they seem like pretty, at least from what I've seen, they seem like pretty mature individuals. So hopefully it'll be mutual, or it was mutual. Hopefully it'll be like, what's the mature and just like, you know, a good co-parenting situation. I think it will. So, and obviously, I mean, I'm sorry, but when unless you're like Blueface and Krishan, when your kid has two famous parents, I'm sure the kid's gonna be okay. Like, I'm sure they're gonna be financially sound. Their parents aren't pieces of shit. So like, I think they're gonna be okay. But on the other end of love, and love being like back, love being so back, Kylie Jenner and Timothee Chalamet have had official public outings lately, which I'm not gonna lie, I was on the side of, oh yeah, PR stunt, when reports were initially coming out that they were dating and stuff, because you only ever saw them in the same place, maybe, just maybe, having a conversation, or like a car that looks like his was at her house, or vice versa, shit like that. You never saw them out together until the Beyoncé concert to start and the US Open. So the Beyoncé concert, I'm not gonna lie, like, obviously they were together, they kissed a couple times, there's video of it, he was ashing a cigarette on the poor people down low, and love it. But the whole kissing, like, he's a great actor, and the whole kissing thing just was like, you know, it made it look like they were just like, I was like, bro, what? Like, you have Kylie fucking Jenner, and Kyle, you have Timothee fucking, two beautiful ass people. I'm like, why are y'all not? But you already are packing on the PDA. You might as well make out. So I wasn't, it looked just weird to me. Like, again, he had his arms around her. They were together. They were dancing great. Everyone does their own shit, but that one was just a little weird. So I was like, oh, okay. Clearly they were together in real life, but I was like, I still don't know what to make of this just yet. Like, I don't know what this is. And then the US Open just a couple days ago, they got photographed together again. And, you know, they both had their arms around each other. He was snapping some pics of her with his little camera, which, side note, I love when celebrities do that, when like they know that there's 1600 cameras on them at all times with amazing, like, they're going to get amazing pictures of themselves. And they know that, like, oh, I'm going to take out my little $120 camera and take a picture of you. Like, you're not doing it. Like, come on. You're not doing anything with that footage. Like, you know you're not. Like, if I know what I know about, you're going to forget that camera exists in a little while. Like, you're taking a picture of someone you're with, so the picture gets taken of you taking a picture of someone you're with. And it's like it's a cool moment. Like, you're not actually taking, celebrities who always have those little dinty cameras that they're taking a picture of someone they're with, and that's, I don't know, that's for someone else to take a picture of you taking a picture of someone to fit the vibe. Like, I just don't. That's just always such a goofy move to me. But that's just my side note on that. But regardless, they were together again, shared some kisses at the US Open. They were watching it go back and forth, watch Coco get that motherfucking win. Shout out Coco. I'm going to dive into that in a second. But yeah, Kylie Jenner and Timothee Chalamet, physically, like, come on now. He's like 140 pounds. Like, don't get me wrong, beautiful individual. But like, how it works, I don't know. Like, she crushes him 100%. I mean, again, Travis Scott was not really some, I mean, I'm sitting here as someone who's not fucking built talking to you and shit, but like, Kylie Jenner, like, in the best, like, yeah, like, you know what I'm talking about. And her and Timothee Chalamet, it's like, I'm rooting for love. So I'm down with it. That's an iconic couple, but just, it's physically, it's funny to see. 'Cause again, he looks like he's like 14 and just like, just found out what a gym was. So I'm excited. I don't know what he's going to do with all that. I'll just put it that way. I don't know what Timothee is going to do with Kylie. I'm not sure, but you know, love is looking good on her. She's dressing more casual and shit. Like, it seems good for her. So obviously I'm a big Kardashian stan. So if you're going to get an iconic relationship, I just got to say, 'cause I'm a Kardashian fan, Timothee, don't fuck up. I said it, and you know, I'm a huge Travis Scott fan. Said the same thing to Trav. He didn't fuck up. I don't want to hear those rumors. Fake. Never saw proof. Timothee, don't fuck up. That's all I'm going to say. So shout out to love. We love love. I'm trying to think. There was one more thing about love that was on my thing. Oh, my God. So it was on Jason Nash's podcast. And this one, because, again, it's more close to home. Natalie and Todd broke up. That's so sad. Again, did I think they were endgame? Probably not. But, like, that's so sad. I wasn't expecting that. And it came out of nowhere. Like, Jason was talking with Todd on his podcast, and it just came out that Natalie and Todd broke up, which I guess I wasn't looking into it that much, because, like, now that I think about it, I have not seen them in a ton of content together, but they have not been in a ton of content together. And they broke up. Todd said, you know, he wasn't at the best place mentally for a little while, and, you know, definitely reflected or took it out on her, and, you know, they're done. They were able to, you know, it seems very, I mean, again, I don't know what goes on behind closed doors, but it seems very mutual. Like, they were kind of joking about it on Jason's podcast. Like, knowing how that friend group is, I doubt it's going to be some whole thing. Like, I'm sure it's going to be able to go back to just being friends and stuff. But I was like, no, like, I was a shipper. I was a shipper of Natalie and Todd. So sucks to see it happen. Hopefully they stay friends. Shout out Natalie and shout out Todd. Hopefully they still keep killing shit. But I was like, no. So, you know, hopefully I could, you know, I'd be mad if I lost Natalie. But, you know, shout out to both of them. I think that'd be dope. And like someone who, you know, is making some breakup albums, Olivia Rodrigo. She's the only one of her peers that's like doing it right now. Like, banger again. Like, Guts, new album, banger. Have I listened to all of it? No. Have I listened to some of the more popular tracks? Yes. But when you're that young, and first off, when your first fucking project, Sour, does what it does, and you have to follow it up with some good shit, she did that. Olivia Rodrigo did that. She's very closely getting to that like iconic level of like, okay, like you're definitely here to stay. You're not going to be like a 2-3 hit wonder. You're not going to be like, yeah. So Olivia Rodrigo's here to stay. New album's fire. And I'm excited to see, she always has some fire ass music videos. So excited to see what those are. But yeah, that's really all I had on Olivia's shit. I thought it was dope. She's kind of bringing out the bars. She's on like a little, like a miniature Taylor run with some first couple albums being fire and shit. So I know there's some beef there. Not sure what beef there is. You know, I'm a big Taylor stan now. So hopefully there is no beef. But shout out Olivia Rodrigo. Album was fire. And she's gonna keep killing shit. She is. I just know she is. That's how it's going to go. Because she's the only one of her peers doing this shit right now. The only other person who's like a newcomer who's... Okay, so I'd say pop right now, of the last couple years, 3-4 years, newcomer, Olivia Rodrigo. Rap, fucking Ice Spice probably. I mean, Travis Scott for me, obviously, but I'm talking newcomers. Ice Spice, country, obviously, it's got to be Zach Bryan. I mean, that dude just has a chokehold over everyone. Country, EDM, I don't fucking know. Absolutely not. Don't listen to EDM. Gospel, beats me. But the three mains, pop, country, and rap, that's Ice Spice, Olivia Rodrigo, Zach Bryan. So that's who I think's running shit. Morgan Wallen's been in the game for a minute, so not talking about Morgan Wallen. And country is at a height right now of popularity. So speaking of that, if I was a hip-hop artist, I simply would not drop on September 22nd. What I mean by that is For All the Dogs, official drop date, September 22nd. Drake's coming back with some shit. Supposedly from Lil Yachty, his dad, other people that have heard it. Going back to the old Drake style, but in some new shit, and it's supposedly going to be really fire. I mean, he just does not have it in him to drop bad music, so I'm certain it's going to be a good album. Is it going to be Take Care, Nothing Was the Same type, iconic as fuck? Views, not sure, but it's going to be fire because it's fucking Drake. So, you know, someone like Lil Tecca and like, don't drop when Drake drops. And when he does, if your album, go to your label. Why the fuck are we dropping on the same day as Drake? It makes no sense. Nobody should be dropping on the same day as Drake. Kanye West dropped on the same day as Drake, and it did not work out. He still got a ton of streams, or he's got not more than Drake, so, like, you probably shouldn't do that. So, yeah, Drake's album, For All the Dogs, coming out. That's going to be fire, and I'm hype about that. Still not sure with, like, the stuff I've... Sorry, I need my Voss water. What, like, the beef between... I wish I could have some, like, actual update of the beef with Drake and Bobby Altoff, but I think it's as simple as, like, it was the Tyga song that he played in her podcast. But, like, I don't know, like, what... He's rich as fuck. Who cares? Like, I don't know why he would be petty enough to take that route. Not sure. So I feel like it's got to be a little deeper than that. But Bobby took a little hiatus, came back and interviewed J Balvin. She just did Shaq. The Offset one isn't happening anymore for some unknown reason. So, yeah, I'm not sure what that whole thing was with Drake and Bobby. That was just a little sidebar because it made me think about it. But regardless, September 22nd for all the dogs. I might just get a dog. I know I just said earlier that dog's not for me, but if you drop in for all the dogs on September 22nd, might as well just get a dog. It's the day after my love's birthday. Emma's birthday is September 21st. Happy early birthday. We're going to Horror Nights at Universal on the 21st. And let me tell you, fucking hype. We've lived here for 2 years. I've been through two Halloweens here. Have not gone to Horror Night yet, because we've been poor and it's like $200. And like, to LA people, oh my God, let's fucking spend that every other hour. I'm poor. That's $200. Definitely need, that's pushing it a little bit for just a night, but doing a little better. But, you know, it was going to be fun. We've wanted to go the last 2 years, so we officially made a plan. We're going to go. So September 21st, we're going to Horror Nights. I don't know why on my sheet I have Beyoncé and U.S. Open. I have no idea why that's written down. But if we're going to talk Beyoncé, when the Eras Tour was happening, shout out Taylor Swift, there was like a tracker for like, oh my God, all the celebs that are going to Taylor's tour, which don't get me wrong, fuck a load of them at every tour date. Like this is, but Beyoncé's show in LA, who the fuck wasn't there? Like I mentioned earlier, Kylie and Timothee, Kendall was there, Kim was there, Chloe was there, Chris was there, Justin and Haley were there, Jay-Z was there, obviously Beyoncé was there, Lizzo was there, Meghan Markle was there, I think Prince Harry went, like, talk about a fucking iconic crowd, Travis Scott was there, oh, Zendaya and Tom Holland were there, like, talk about a fucking iconic crowd, jeez, and that also makes me think that there was just this funny video that I swear Tom Holland forgets he's famous sometimes. Like, the way he presents himself in his relationship, which I fucking love. Like, if Emma were to get famous, I'm gonna just be in background. Like, if your girlfriend's famous, if your girlfriend is Zendaya, yeah, you take that backseat. You do. Tom Holland is doing the right thing. You just sit back. You admire. It's kind of like, almost like what ASAP Rocky does with Rihanna. Like, I know ASAP has his own shit going on. He has his own shows and what, but ASAP does a very good job of like, oh, this is my woman right here. This is her night. She's the shit. Like, ASAP does that very well with Rihanna and just being like, yeah, I have a queen right here. So like, I'm going to let her do her queen shit. I'm going to be in the background. So shout out ASAP. Tom Holland, man. Like, as they're walking into Beyonce, Zendaya's walking like 5 steps ahead of him. He's just like back ducking, taking a video of her walking. And I'm like, do not remember that you're fucking Spider-Man. One of the highest grossing movie franchises of all time. That's you. And I just find it so funny. So yeah, Tom Holland's fucking awesome. He's on one of those lists of celebrities I would really like to meet. I feel like Tom Holland would be a fun time hanging out with. So yeah, it was iconic. There was all that going on. It was hectic. Speaking of concerts, Gunna, again, I talked about this in like episode 1 and 2 of my podcast. I don't know where I stand with it. Like, Gunna gets freed. And at first I'm like, yo, y'all don't know the real story. Like, don't be so quick to judge. Like, who knows what ended up happening. And then a couple other people spoke out against him. So I was like, whoa, wait. And Young Thug kind of threw a shot in one of his songs. So I was like, whoa, what's going on here? I'm not sure. Maybe I was wrong. But Gunna just had a show at Barclays Center in Brooklyn, which he sold out the arena, by the way, which, again, rappers are having a hard time selling out arenas. Gunna is different. Gunna, he's got that essence. He's a star. Gunna is a star. Like, he's going to be able to sell out shit. So I thought that was dope. But in his show, he rapped, obviously, the song Hot, which got him, Young Thug, and Travis, and he rapped Young Thug's part of the song, And while he was doing that on the big screen or whatever, he said, "Free Jeffrey." Obviously, if you don't know, Jeffrey's Young Thug's real name. So then that had me thinking, like, was I wrong about being wrong? And I was right. Because, like, if not, then that's almost like a taunt where it's like, yeah, I'm singing your part and saying free you while you sit in jail. Like, there's so much that I don't know. But again, like, Young Thug could absolutely, yo, at my lawyer, go put out a statement saying, yo, Gunna, I love, like, I'm not sure what's really going on there, but he did say free Jeffrey at his concert, sold the fuck out of Barclays Center, which is crazy. And yeah, so that's been going on in the music world, which is crazy. Another one, football is so back. Football is so very back, and like back to the point where literally Saturdays and Sundays, every week you have something to look forward to. Now, generally, I like to be an optimist about, I usually have some fun shit to look forward to, even if it's fucking going out to long, it's some shit like that, some simple shit. But football being back every Saturday and Sunday and Thursday and Monday sometimes, you have shit to look forward to. And football was back as fuck. First off on the list, as I'm sure a lot of people in the country are obsessed with Colorado. I am. Obviously, they were talked about big coming into the year. Prime, Deion Sanders, head coach, transfer portal getting, I think it was like 80 new players on their roster. Obviously, his two sons, Shiloh and Schroeder. Sanders, obviously, they have Travis Hunter, like number one prospect in the country, was about to go to Florida State, decided to come back, like, well, not come back, but decided to go to Colorado. So, like, so much talk. They're 2-0 right now. Now, again, they haven't played Georgia yet, haven't played Alabama yet, haven't played Ohio State or Michigan yet, but 2-0 at the moment. They went to TCU on the road, won that. Schroeder threw for like 500 fucking yards, and Travis Hunter played like 1,400 snaps. And at home, they just beat Nebraska. Schroeder threw for like another 300 something yards. Yeah, I think they're here. They're here. And as a lot of people are saying, you know, I'm not going to be one of those people like, yeah, the Buffs are, you know, they're going to win the Big Ten, Pac-12. I think they're Pac-12. Whatever. But they're, yeah, I'm not one of those people that's like, yeah, they're going to go to the national championship and they're going to win, blah, blah, blah. Like, I do realistically see a bowl game. I do. Call me crazy. I see a bowl game. Deion's different. Their team is young, hungry, fire. I'm on the Colorado bandwagon heavy. I'm just going to say it. I'm not going to be a hypocrite about it. I'm not going to lie about it. I'm on the Colorado train heavy. I think they're going to be fucking dope. They have just like such a dope ass aura to the team from their coach. It's in fucking Boulder, Colorado. Beautiful mountains in the background of the stadium. Dope ass team. So I'm fully on with Colorado. Hopefully they keep winning and college football is fucking back. Now, NFL is fucking back. Now, I don't know if I think I talked about it in a couple episodes. I'm a Bears fan, but I'm a Bears fan at heart. And then if the Bears aren't going to make the Super Bowl, which they're really not going to any year, obviously, you know, I'm going to have another team to root for on top of the Bears. Because I'm not going to go into the Super Bowl and not want someone to win. Of course I do. Like, that's, I'm a sports lover. I want someone to win. I enjoy watching the game. So this year, since my dad is a huge fan of them, I am adopting the Miami Dolphins as my team this year on top of the Bears. You're welcome. And week one, got that dub over the Chargers. They went fucking ham. Tua, I'm part of Tua-non, which is dope. Tyreek Hill is just fucking built different, as we all knew, but he's just built more different. So yeah, Dolphins went crazy. Joe Burrow, you know, signed a $250 million contract. Basically, it was nowhere to be found, but they lost to the Browns before in game one. So not going to judge that too much, but football's back, baby. Sundays are back. I'm hype. I'm back. Not really back. I didn't go anywhere, but we back here. And I'm really trying to think, like, I hit on some fun-ass points. You know what I mean? Like, it's episode 10. Like I said, I officially have guests coming in. We're going to do it. I know I would have loved to do episode 10 for the first guest, but Fashion Week calls. It happens. And no, I'm hyped. Honestly, like, we're going to have more guests. I'm trying to think if there's anything I wanted to touch on before we end up going. Yes, Fashion Week in New York. Obviously, everyone's going to, you know, be out and about there. So New York's buzzing right now, which makes me sad because I want to be in New York so badly. But, you know, we'll go back to New York soon. Ooh, the D'Amelio show, September 20th. You better tune the fuck in, D'Amelio show. Watch that shit. Trust me. But yeah, that's really kind of like all the updates I got for y'all at the moment, but it's been a fun ass episode. Shout out episode 10. We're going to be doing more of these. So, and I said, going to get guests, going to find a fire co-host at some point. So on that note, I'm hype and peace. Oh,